Hello for Friday, June 10th. This is the Dow. You can see one day we ran below that 61.8% Fibonacci. Just one on Wednesday, and on Thursday we did bounce up. The volume wasn't very big, but we did go up 75 points, about 0.6% of a percent move. And who's to say whether it's a one-day thing or not? We would like to get above that April low if it would mean something. We can look at the futures chart. It's a 60-minute of the Dow futures. And you can see from the low, this was the recent high point. And, of course, it came down and tested it once. It tested it a second time. So this was the obvious breakout line, and that would be our zero line coming back up, or actually our 100% retracement line. So we then gave us a 161% at 12,146, and actually you can see the left-hand side. Usually if it gets that far, a lot of times it will test the highs, which it did, actually exceeded them. But by then you can see the RSI did get up to the 70 line, and it was a little bit too much too soon for it. In the one day, it had already gone above our two, and quite often you're not going to get up to our three in a day. That's unusual. So usually there's some pullback, but it did pull. You can see for a couple hours, 1, 2, 3 hours, it held above the 161.8. But then in the last 2 hours, once it cracked that, you can see that just created, you know, a continuous selling. That's where people had their stop. So it went through there, and of course through R2 they came on. But look, it held above the breakout, held above even the 12102, which is the center Bollinger band of 20 days. So the area to watch that was the 12093. If it can hold that breakout, we're fine. It's just a pullback from the day. Some people were upset that we didn't close at the high, but you know, after a big down day, you take what you can get. It wasn't so bad a move. You can see on the weekly for the Russell, it had gone down the trend line. It didn't bounce very much. The Russell just hasn't moved much at all. You can see just a little bit of a, just a little hint of a move up here. So it's got a, there's this little gap up here. So we'll wait and see what happens with that. We're not even posting a futures chart of it because it just, it's just not that interesting now. But we do have a SP coming up that will be more interesting. So we can see we're still on the weekly below the trend line. We've got to get more action to do much on that. And this, of course, that daily, and our beautiful bull flag that didn't work out. And here we have a just showing the bounce on the 60-minute as it went up and closed under the 20-period EMA on the 60-minute. Now, this is more interesting when we look at the futures chart of this. When we posted it at midnight, which, first off, I'm on the wrong chart. Well, we'll mention this while I'm right here. This is the euro. And you can see early in the morning they had some announcement. It started to move up a little bit, but then it also dropped below. This is both the 161 projection off of this low up to this breakout point at 14331. And it ran above that, and you can say we said this was a significant line because it's also the 61.8% retracement of this total move down. So as soon as it dropped below that, you could watch it on the daily chart. You would just see this candle growing. It did get a bounce, but right away. And that's because it was a significant level. When you have converging Fibonacci lines, pay attention. And in that case, that just triggered some action. Okay, now we'll go to that the S&P futures chart. And so you can see at the bottom, this 161.8% projection, it has a zero line here. You can't, maybe I can move this over if I have it on the chart. And we've posted it before, so you'll know it. We had rallied down, and we had rallied up to this high level. It came down to this long red candle down, and then it rallied back up again. So as it came down to that same area, once again, that's the 100% retrace. So it came down to the 100% retrace, and then down to the 161.8. This, it hit last night at the market closed, and right away, we started back up right at the close. And when we posted it at midnight, anyway, we had a trend line here. This, I won't explain. Anyway, there was a trend line here, and we just went over that, broke out of that trend line, I believe. You can check the Twitter feed, but, you know, we'd already started up anyway at midnight, and it continued, and you see. So this, it was right at the 161 and down, and this was the breakout line, the 1286, and you can see that we had run up to that line, was able, and we failed it the first time. So our 161.8, that's where we ran to. So we ran from 161.8 on the downside to 161.8 on the upside. So it's logical we should pull back and look. We pulled back and we haven't broken the high. I'm not the high, the breakout, which is 1286.42. And even if we did, if we can hold above the 1285.59, that is the center Bollinger Band, that still would be bullish. So don't be upset by a little bit of a pullback at the end of the day. It doesn't mean much until it does, and it doesn't right now. Anyway, our gold, this is a daily chart, and you can see not much happened. It went up $5, but it didn't change any of the settings we have. Silver's been moving slowly. It looks like it's going up, then it doesn't. And so this is just stagnant at the moment. And we run in those periods. We have big, sweeping, long, big moves, and then periods of stagnation where it's just not a good trading vehicle. And you don't have to trade it just because it's mechanical. You don't have to trade every move. All right, so let's get on to something else. Maybe first, let me just quickly do this because it's the weekend, and I'll just take another moment to do so. We looked at these before. That shows the bounce. That was the SPX. It didn't get down as low as at 1262. That's still a possibility. We'll show these in the weekend. This was the one that someone had asked me about the bounce, and we said watch that 20-day or increased volume. It did indeed move. It made that little hammer yesterday, and it moved up above it. Isn't above that breakout line, and the volume isn't big either. I'm just mentioning it because we had that chart open from yesterday. Now we lowered this lower trend line because it isn't a valid trend line until we move off of it enough and then come back and test it. But right now it's a test trend line, and this is the mid caps because they had been so strong. If so, we start getting some good bounces, we may get up a ways, come back and test it again, and if that's successful, then we could look to a breakout on the upside. So we will be watching that as the weeks progress. And the BKX, we showed this daily chart how it come down to this lower trend line, and it did bounce up a big 1%, 55 cents is all, but it did. It stayed within that, so hey, it means something. And here's silver. Didn't move up a lot. It moved up 1.78%, but it moved it above that little trend line and above this horizontal that we don't have drawn there. And I think there's one more chart in this series. Then we will indeed move on. And that is the GLD. And you can see it didn't move up. It moved up 0.5%, just a tiny thing. And it's on that little trend line. Okay, so now what happened during the day? What happened is some stocks that had triggered in the past, not those aren't the stocks, but they will be coming. Cool is one that we're waiting for. It's coming. There we go. Okay, so Cool is one that had broken out a couple days back, and then yesterday it really moved, and look, today it added another 9%, but it's getting up here in this resistance is 47.408. It could be a breakout again, but look, it's totally above the top Bollinger Band. When that happens, don't be shy nor bashful. Take profits. We're not in the screaming bull at the very moment. This didn't do anything. I'm just pointing. It started to do something. HEV, we're just watching that. ARIA triggered normally today. ARIA pharmaceuticals, you know, biotech. We like biotech, as you know. So this one moved up about 5%, and it triggered just the normal way. Well, it's a couple other ones triggered with a big gap. This one wasn't a very good trade, but because it gapped up, but you can see it gapped up under the 50-day, and then it moved above it quickly and then back down. This, because it's a low-valued stock, if we hadn't seen that it's been dropping for a long time, you'd almost think it was one of those pumping dumps where it has low volume, then huge volume comes in as the insiders bail, and maybe they're pumping it. But anyway, I don't know the situation here. We just showed it because we said it's probably, if you can get it during an active trading session, there's a lot of volatility, and it did run like 20% up and down during the day. FRX triggered normally today. Force Labs, once again in the medical and pharmaceuticals, and it had a nice clean. This was a continuation play, and it did just exactly that. It dropped a little bit lower than yesterday, and then it moved up from there. This one was a great trade. This was a really nice trade as far as using the 15-minute rule. It gapped up pretty good, but look, this was set up to do something strong, and it's in an area of the market that's, you know, is like a sweetheart at the moment. anyway, it gapped up. So we mentioned, you know, always on these gap ups, always at least check your 5-minute chart if you're interested in playing this. But already the volume was screaming right from the get-go. And whenever you have big volume, and this was up, I don't know, 400-500% volume. Look at this volume. Usually it's way down under a million, and it was a 3.8 million. So this is what the 5-minute chart looks like. The 15-minute gap rule uses the first 3 5-minute bars with a line at the lower of the three and a line at the top. And it hit the top one was the second bar, so that in the third one too. But this was the high of the first three bars at 10, 12, and then it took another 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and 30 minutes. This arrow should be over one. That's when it broke out. That was by 10, 12, and then you can use, this is your own personal judgment. My opinion, I like to watch the RSI and also the 9-period EMA for a closing candle. Underneath it is a possible exit, depending on a lot of other factors like your trading style and how much you have invested, what profit you've taken, and so forth. But so you can see that was the buy. It ran right away up over a buck. It came down. It didn't have any closing candles over here. Then it ran to 1239. And just as it started down right here, we had a break. We actually had a little break here below the RSI, but the candle held. It didn't close underneath. Anyway, it broke right here. So that may have been your exit on this candle right there. So you're up a buck. If not, you could get back in over there. Anyway, just showing that it was a very good trade. It was up over 20% if you bought, not at the gap, but if you bought using this rule, you still made 20% on your money. So not too bad. EQY, we wanted to point out this because when we pointed it out, we said, but we didn't put it on the watch list that way. We said, look, this is a very weak stock, but since we had this candle up, it could be a bounce. You see where it bounced to the 50-day, and those are the typical places weak stocks bounce up to where? Moving averages or trend lines or other resistance. This moved right back up to the trend line, couldn't hold it, so it broke down and there triggered on the short side during the day. Another one just worthy of a mention, just because it triggered actually a while back just for a day, and then it pulled back and then it gapped down. But we still were watching it, and this one broke back above with much higher volume on the day. Cigna Group. And the last one, just to watch for, there's others to watch too, but since this one didn't trigger, we won't wait to the horizontal, but it did trigger above the trend line if you're watching a Baker Hughes on that. Okay, now finally to the additions to the watch list. VICL, first off, I like the fact that we've had some increased volume days. Mainly, it's stuck between the 20-day on the upside and the 50-day on the downside, and they maybe will last a while. Watch the area over 408 or 410 if the volume comes in. I realize over here on the left there's this resistance, but look at that nice long candle last time it boosted up. A lot of times they can repeat that procedure. We would hope so. Anyway, if interested in this one, just set an alert and look at the volume. If the volume's really good at 408, 410, that might be good. PXP had a nice 2-day run, and this is one of those ones that have like a dollar trading area in there, and those sometimes can be good because they don't have resistance at the high side. It's 3850, 3830 area. That resistance is later, so sometimes there's not much resistance going to it. That's the idea that sometimes works out. So PXP 37.36 might be an area on that. FOSL, this has kind of got a little triangle slanted just a bit, and a rectangle, I guess you call it, not what a triangle, a rectangle. Yeah, I know math. I'm real good at geometry. So here we go. Anyway, 107.54 is the upside there, but 106.75 about would get you above this little trend line. Had improving volume the last 2 days as well. And so maybe this is ready to break from this range. DRV over $13.21. It puts it over the 50-day as well, over the high of the day. It's not perfect. It has a bunch of resistance over here, but it is a month, more than a month away, and it does have improving volume, which is pretty good. Can you hum Humana? healthcare, you know, over about $80.83 could get it out of this congestion pattern. IPG is another one to watch, over about $12.05. Another one that has this little trading area in there that might be beneficial with the partway covered by this long red candle. So it might be just a scalp in there of 10, 30, 40 cents, but it might develop into something more. So watch IPG for improved volume. And then lastly, we have WPI over $64.75 would be put it over the high. And it had good volume on Thursday, less volume on the pullback on Friday, and we like to see that. So that's it. We have a weekend coming up, a summer weekend, so I hope you go out and enjoy that. I will have a newsletter coming out. It's free. Just sign up on the homepage with your email address, and we'll get that out to you on Sunday. Otherwise, we'll be through the day on Friday. We'll send out tweets of interest. Hopefully, they are helpful. And, of course, on Sunday, we'll also have a new video with some additional watch list ideas. So, thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Have a good night.